And I say congratulations to him. First of all, on a 3-1 record, but you weren't expected to do that. They thought it was a little fun being the underdog most of the time. It was a surprise. And then, back in 3 months, you would all be second lieutenants.
With a little luck, something.
The Army will be better for it. I think I'm supposed to stand over here someplace.
Sir, we have something we'd like to give you from the seniors on the National Football Team. We'd like to tell you that we're very honored to be the recipients of this trophy, and we're very proud to be able to serve the nation for your leadership. And we'd like to give you a varsity letter sweater that we wear at the academy. The gold star on the bottom is for our victory over Navy, and the silver star is for our victory over Air Force. Typically, sir, we would have one gold star in the middle of the A to represent team captain. But since you are our captain and our commander-in-chief, we have 5 stars for you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
I'm very proud to have had the opportunity to present this, emblematic of the wins over the other two. And while I flew a desk in World War II for the Air Force, it was then the Army Air Force. And I was a second lieutenant too in the reserve. Went on from there. So it was all Army all the way, and I'm very proud and happy to be able to have a hand in this. So all the way.
Well, thank you.
Thanks.
Yes.
Well,
here's the superintendent, Mr. President.
Yes, sir.
General Scott.
Good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
Only way to go is to win.
Yes, I had an awful lot of the other experiences. I played in a little school that our coach believed, and I know now he was right in looking back. He played us above our heads all the time. We played schools about 10 times our size. So we broke even. We thought it was a great season. But once, when some of us kind of asked about it, he asked us, well, whether we would like to remember that we beat some little college that everybody said, where is it? And or would we like it better if we were playing the field and was okay, so we lost, but in a respectable fashion and with someone of some size and prestige. The only time I thought he was really wrong was the night that we went up against James Milliken University. And I was running the hard way 175 miles. I looked at the man opposite me, who later would be 8 years old pro tackle with the Chicago Bears, George Musso, at 275 Well, this is just great. I'm very proud to have you all here. Proud of what you've done.
Secretary of Defense told us, and we saw this morning, it'd be great to come over and watch the old Gipper give us the commander-in-chief.
But of course, that was a great triumph, too. You know, yes, after 8 years playing in the line, there isn't a line that doesn't really believe you're in a hell of a good back, is there? Able to carry the ball in the first play, 85 yards for a touchdown. I kept thinking to myself, yeah, it's right, we could have been. Well, I'm very proud, as I say, have a hand in doing this, but that's all. You earned it. I congratulate all of you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Mr. President, could we have you pause for a team photo, please? One more time.
Hold it
right
there. Just for my own sake, at least one of those.
can't see your A, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Carl, why don't you hear from Carl?
Thank you.
There is a director of athletics, too. It's probably all right.
Isn't it true that over the field house, there is that inscription, the general in the guard area, the field house, down those these fields?
And the one up by the football stadium, the marshals have a dangerous mission. Send me a West Point football.
All right.
Yeah, I'll do it again, sir.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you,
Mr.
President.
Thank you all.
See you next year, same time.
Wonderful. You're so kind.
Do it again next
time.
Yeah.
All right.
We'll look forward
to that. Yeah. Matter of fact, just go to the next one.
And General Paul.
Hi. How are you,
sir?
Nice to see you. Hey, thank you very much, sir.
Give you a little something.
Some of this today.
Little snack in the background there.
Out of my bottom drawer of the desk there.
Well, Joan is coming in. The other three children are off doing their duty other parts of the world, but at least you have
yes,
some of this.
Yes. Hi, Joan. How are you? Let's get a good picture here.
Fine. Great. Higgins sent a message via this Marine. President, you want to tell the President what some of the other Marines around here have told you?
Mr. President, Secretary Regan mentioned to me that some bone Marine stories have been going around.
And you want to stop.
Well, no, it was the other day, yesterday, as a matter of fact, in there with some senators. And one of them evidently had been in the Navy, and so Don and George were all sitting up there. Bud McFarland and everything, and he uttered the line. Apparently, he stood up and he was talking to them, and he said, "You know, I tried to get in the Marines first, but he said I couldn't qualify. My parents were married."
A couple of points before we walk across to a very wonderful group of people. In addition to going back to the ranch and taking care of at least one white horse. I'll be associating on a part-time basis of counsel with William Rogers, former Attorney General and Secretary of State. Bill Rogers is out here today.
Oh.
And I want to be sure that you're out of the Los Angeles firm. And of course, I'm chairing that nuclear commission you asked me to do last week, so that'll keep us busy too. But also, flying back here for just this half hour, Phoebe Cook. San Francisco, and Kay Haley from Ventura County.
Are they in something? Oh, yeah.
But I thought Bill Rogers particularly because he's helped us in so many ways the last 4 years. So, and Cap just gave me the, this is just the rosette, but his Distinguished Service Medal. So it's been a big day for the Clarks, but the best, of course, is being with you.
What I was just doing in there. I was presenting the 27 seniors of the West Point football team. They won the big trophy. The trophy that goes to the three service academies. There's a giant thing with three silver footballs on it. Did he know it? And they this year beat both Navy and the Air Force. So is it the Air Force Academy? So they get the big trophy.
Yeah, so Jack Bessie will probably join us across the hallway too. But I thought Phoebe and there was Kay and guess you're all wondering why we asked you here.
That used to be a line in most detective stories. Well, this is a time of mixed emotions. One of them, great pride, and a little bit of guilt complex within me, because I'm responsible for 19 years of public service of the highest on the highest order by Bill Clark, and the guilt is that I at least had a 6-year furlough in there in Washington. I'd be a civilian again for a while, but he had to go the full 19 years, had him trapped in some of those positions. But the service has been above and beyond the call of duty for all those 19 years. And I've been more than proud to have him here as a part of this administration and then as a part of the team in Sacramento before that. And we're going to miss him very much. But I can't really resent or regret too much where he's going, because going to a ranch in California should be the ultimate dream of anyone. And it certainly is mine. And Bill, just a little souvenir so you won't forget us. Don't break them. Or throw them in the fireplace. Okay.
Well, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, I rarely argue with my boss, but not trapped at all for 18 or 19 years. What greater privilege could a man or a family have in serving a man and a cause that they truly believe in? And we did, we do, and we will, Mr. President. And having been one small part of your great policies, particularly the one I had address earlier this afternoon, peace through strength, and not just military strength, but economic strength, moral strength. We've loved every minute of it, and along with the other alumni, we'll be pushing those same principles in California. So thank you very, very much, Mr. President.
Thank you. One Clark still in service. Drink and be merry. Have fun.
Kay and Phoebe flew out this morning.
Yes.
Many other old friends from California. Frank Richardson over here on the left.
Hi, Frank.
Formerly of our state Supreme Court and still at Interior. And we welcome you all.
Well, it's a great pleasure to have you, Bill. I see you. Well, pleased and honored to have you all come in here. I know Bill feels that same way. Now, if you'd really like to have another one of these next week, you know you could come back to do something. Hi, how are you doing? Good to see you. Well, please. Have a party.
So, I know you've got to get back to work, Mr. President, but appreciate everything.
Hey, that's the only thing I haven't found out about. Where is that fellow that puts the paper on my desk every day that tells me what I have to do?
That's Bill Gawara.
You know, America's Leadership Institute.
Mr. President, we have, as Casey Casey says, Arab Americans from coast to coast. John Zogby.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
Arab American Institute.
Pleasure to meet you.
Samir Tota from the American Federation of Rural Palestine.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. President. David Scott, National Association of Arab Americans.
Nice to see you.
Good morning, Mr. President. Susan Ziad, Association of Arab American University graduates.
My name is Jim Zogby. Mr. President, Casey Kasem, American Arab tourist base. Well, nice to meet you.
Well, I'm assisting your office.
She doesn't look Arab. I ought to creep in here.
Yeah, one of you.
Yeah. Group shot?
Group picture.
Have a group picture. I think he's only going to squeeze in.
Could we get a...
there we go.
And every time
we get
together,
I really appreciate you.
No, I stopped talking because last time I took a picture with you, my eyes were closed and I was talking.
Well, I know you're not all Republicans, but I also know, though, that the Vice President, they're most grateful for the support that your community gave us in the last campaign. As a matter of fact, Arab American volunteers in our campaign were in the greatest number of any ethnic group involved in the campaign.
Man right here who did it.
Nice. Everyone together, working together for your candidacy. We were very supportive of you and appreciate the fact that your campaign was the first to have an Arab Americans for Reagan Bush Committee in the history of political campaigns in the United States.
And I think that what that meant for us was that whether we're Republicans or Democrats, we were proud that Arab Americans had that opportunity, that you gave it to them, and that they performed well and therefore earned respect in the process of doing that.
Americans should have a great sense of gratitude for the contributions that you've made to the Arab community, Arab American community.
Thank you. You should be proud to know that you led the way for the Democrats. They were behind you on that one. Long.
We have a conference this weekend, Mr. President.
No.
Building Tomorrow, Laying the Political Foundation. We brought in 200 Arab American leaders from across the country. Coast to coast, as Casey Kasem says, to participate. We're having Senator Dole speak to them. We're having a briefing this afternoon with Mr. Murphy and someone at Mr. Regan's office. And it's a new dawn for Arab Americans. And
well, I
we appreciate
you to get involved in the political activities. I think it'll be good for you. It'll be good for the country. And so no one should be left out of that practice. One word about the Middle East. I don't know how you all feel, but I've been greatly encouraged by the progress of the love that King Hussein and Egypt relationship now that has been established and the talks that have been going forward. And I hope that one day the initiative that we started 2 years ago can begin to move. Stand ready to do everything we can.
We want to see the full Palestinian participation in this, and I know that that's so necessary for there to be peace, that their legitimate representatives need to be brought in.
Yes.
A positive gesture would be so important from us to them to further that process.
I don't want to say anything here that might get to be controversial. No, I agree with that, but I don't agree with this idea that some are having over there that we should bring this into a great international meeting.
Yeah.
I think then you're going to be hampered by differences between countries not even involved in the Middle East, but who will sit at the table and conscious of their own difference with someone else at the table.
Mr. President, I'm convinced that only our country, under your leadership, can actually bring the Arabs and the Israelis to the peace table. And I firmly believe that now the Palestinians, the Jordanians, the Egyptians, the Saudis, and all the Arab side wants to get to the peace table. And the thing I think it needs most at the appropriate time is for you to step forward and say, I'm ready to bring you together.